Here we go.
Was on the same page with Alex, all those guys.
Hey, y'all. Welcome to the Charles Norman Show. I'm in bed today. Not doing a regular setup. Not dancing. And there's a reason. My back hurts really badly. So this is the most comfortable position that I could sit in and do the show. And I want to do a show because I haven't done one in a very long time. So I decided, let's do one today. I know we missed 2 Mondays, which means last week was the Eagles bye week, so I wasn't doing shows that week. But I want to do one on Monday. So remember the last time I did Inspiration, a long time ago, it was a 3-parter. So I'm just going to do all 3 parts on Monday, just so we can catch up. Well, the Eagles played it. Well, it's time to start the show. Hey, Eagles play the Cowboys on Sunday Night Football this week. I only have one thing to say. Eagles better win, or I will be pissed off. All right, moving on to my picks. I got Buffalo winning, Carolina winning, Minnesota winning, New England winning, New Orleans winning, New York Jets winning, Oakland, St. Louis, New York Giants, Denver, and of course the Eagles beating the Cowboys. All right, so we're going to have some hot topics. Bendy Irwin, you all know who Bendy Irwin is. She's the daughter of the crocodile hunter, Steve Irwin. She's on Dance with the Stars, but her contract for Dance with the Stars has been rejected by an LA judge. She's 17, so she had to submit a minor contract to the judge. And the judge rejected it because he or she, I don't know what it was, needs proof. Oh, I got this damn TV on. Sorry. He or she needs proof that her father is dead. I just got a question for the judge. Have you been alive for more than 20 years? Are you as old as I am? Because if you are, you should know who the hell a crocodile hunter is, and you should know that the man is dead. He died years ago. What was it, in 2006 in the summertime? He got killed by a stingray. So how do you not know? Well, I mean, what kind of proof do you need? You need a death certificate to make sure he's dead, to make sure he ain't somewhere swimming around the ocean, make sure he didn't turn into a damn mermaid. Is that what it is? Crazy. But right now, she's earned $230,000 from being on the show. And it'll only continue to add up because she's a good dancer. And I don't think she'll be off the show for a while. This is week, she's made it to week 8 in the Dancing with the Stars competition already. She may make it farther. I know she'll at least get past week 9. Alright, so let's talk about the 2016 election. And I'm just going to go down some bullet points for each of the candidates. And you guys tell me what you think about him too. Donald Trump. Well, for one, he's losing his fire. He's not ahead in all the polls like he was before. And he's been pretty damn quiet since he made those comments about 9/11 and George Bush. He is going to host Saturday Night Live on this Saturday night, tomorrow night. So make sure you guys watch it. There you go, Donald. I'm giving you some free publicity. I think the Saturday Night Live appearance will finish him off. Because I think they're going to try to gear it to be very, I don't know what's the word I'm looking for. I think it's going to go against them in a bad way. Well, there's only one way you can go against them, and that is in a bad way. In an SNL promo that was supposed to be pulled, but was leaked, he was recorded saying that Ben Carson is a huge loser. You know how Donald always goes like this, he's a loser. You ever notice how he talks? His eyes, you see how my eyes are, it's like he's always like, his eyes are always like that, like he's trying to make a mean face and he's always talking like this. You know, you guys are losers, I'm gonna win, you're gonna lose. Hillary Clinton, she's a fraud. That's how he talks. Alright, moving on a bit. Oh, I expect him to start saying some stupid stuff really soon. Ben Carson, he's the new front runner. This guy is weirdly stupid. And when I say weirdly stupid, I just mean he's a different kind of stupid. It's not like your normal stupidity. He's just a crazy stupid. He said the Egyptians didn't build the pyramids. Joseph did with the help of God. Well, you know, Joseph might have helped build the pyramids, and God, I'm sure, did help those people build the pyramids, but these, and he said there were no, like, kings and pharaohs and queens and all that stuff in there. There were. There's proof. People actually went in there before it was made public to see. There was people that they were putting in those pyramids and tombs. You know what? For somebody that's running for president, his ass don't know history. If I had to go to history class, and everybody else in America had to go to history class, I didn't even send his ass back to history class saying stupid stuff like that. We know them pyramids. Joseph might have helped them, but them damn Egyptians built them pyramids. He out there spreading wrong, false information. What the hell is wrong with that guy? So stupid. He's also sending out a rap ad on the radio, trying to get the young blacks to vote for him. Well, Mr. Carson, not all young blacks listen to rap music. And even if we all did listen to rap music, we ain't gonna vote for you because you stupid. And that's not nice to say, but he is stupid. And you know what? If I had to choose between him and Donald Trump, I would choose Donald Trump. Because Donald Trump, at least he's not... Like, when Carson was high in his ignorance, Donald Trump was all out in the open with his ignorance the whole time. This guy, he just scares me. He ain't go back to doing some surgery. Actually, don't even do any surgery, because you crazy. You was cool at one point, but now you just crazy. All right, moving on, Jeb Bush. Jeb Bush is poor malarkey. This new campaign slogan is, Jeb can fix it. Does he think he's Bob the Builder? Is he like some type of handyman? What the hell is he doing? What is he going to fix? He says he's a weak debater. Well, Jeb, how do you think you're going to get elected president if you're a weak debater? You're a loser. That's what you are. A huge loser. He had a meeting with his dad and his brother, two former presidents, and donors to his campaign to save his campaign because it's on life support and he sucks. I guess all they came up with was Jeb can fix it. I mean, if he's smart, he'll do what his brother did and just walk into the White House without really getting elected by the people. Carly Fiorina. She blames liberals for everything. She gets on my nerves. She blames Hillary Clinton for everything. She's so freaking annoying. She literally fell with almost every business thing that she's been a part of. She lost her little bit of fire that she had after that first debate because she's weird. She is. She's really weird. She called out the ladies of The View for saying that she looked demented in like a Halloween costume because of the way she smiled at the debate. She said, "People say I don't smile enough. But here you go." Like, I look demented right there. But I'm not going to say that she looked demented because everybody will say that I'm being, you know, rude. But if I, you all can say it about me. I'm sorry, I ain't even.